Hi guys, this is going to be a video answering the question, how did your hair grow so fast? And the thing is, I don't think my hair grew that fast at all. I think in January it was probably up to here, and now it's down to my hips. So maybe it did grow quite fast, I'm not sure. But every single time when I launch out a video and my hair is straight and I have done nothing to it, there's always someone who says, oh my gosh, your hair is so long, how did it grow so fast? And then I get a few people who are like swearing to God that these are extensions. So no, they're not extensions, so I'm just gonna show you right now that my hair is real. See, no extension guys, all hair, no clip-ins, nothing. No infusion, none of that crazy extensions that they have nowadays. And then I'm probably gonna get another question if this is real as well. And yes, this is my real hair going across my forehead. And then use a clip in this time because my hair is finally long enough for me to braid it and put it across my forehead. By the way, I just wanted to let you guys know that it is raining right now, so you're gonna hear a little bit of thunderstorm going on. And yeah, I was just kind of really upset about it, but I love the rain, so it's kind of like a love-hate relationship. Okay, so hair basically grows about half an inch to about an inch every single month. Maybe a little bit slower for some people, a little bit faster for others. My hair, I would have to say about an inch every single month. And that's because I don't put as much heat in my hair as people think I do. I would have to say that I straighten out my hair maybe 3 times a week. And I try to do that every other day. And when I really do damage to my hair, it's usually in a video when I am teasing, braiding, adding all this product in my hair. Every single day, I would actually go to school without any product in my hair. And the only product I would probably use is like a heat protectant or just like a leave-in conditioner just to have it nice and moist. I'm not saying that you shouldn't tease, flat iron, or do anything crazy with your hair. You know, we're girls, our best main accessory is our hair, and so you might as well work it, right? But for those of you who do want to grow your hair out or who just had a really bad haircut and just want to grow like maybe 1 to 2 inches out, there's a few things that I do recommend, and the list is going to start right now. The first thing I would recommend doing is having a really good shampoo and having a really amazing conditioner. I used to use Paul Mitchell Super Skinny Shampoo and Conditioner, and that's like the one thing that I swear by because it is so amazing. It makes your hair grow so fast, and it's just really, really, really awesome on your hair. It just strengthens your hair, and I love that shampoo so, 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 so much. Now the thing is, it's kind of expensive. A bottle is about $20, so if you buy this shampoo and the conditioner, you're going to run yourself $40. Also, you should try to wash your hair maybe once a day or every other day if your hair is a little bit drier. I have to wash my hair once a day because, again, I have oily hair. It's pretty gross. I live with it. And you should also consider deep conditioning your hair at least once a week. People get deep conditioning and leave-in conditioners confused, but they're actually two different things. A conditioner is what you would put in your hair while you're in the shower for about maybe 3 to 5 minutes while you're shaving your legs or something. A leave-in conditioner, it usually comes in a spray bottle, and you would just spritz it on. It doesn't have that concentrated amount of conditioner in it. You'll spray it on and you'll leave it in all day, or you can spray it on before you flat iron your hair. Now a deep conditioner is basically using your conditioner, applying it on your hair, and then wrapping a hot towel over it for about 20 to 30 minutes. There's a huge difference in those three, and you should try to use maybe all three of them in a week. Condition your hair every single time you wash it, leave-in conditioner, basically spray it on before you go to school or something and just leave it on, or doing a deep conditioner at least once a week. I wouldn't do it more than once a week because if your hair gets too oily, it will clog up the follicles of your hair and it could fall out. Okay, for deep conditioners, there's two things I really do recommend you doing. It's one, taking your favorite conditioner, the ones that you would shower with every single day, and I would basically, with your hair damp, you're gonna put it on the tips of your hair, and then a little bit maybe on the top of your hair, wrap it up in a hot towel, and what you'll do is you'll take a towel, moisten it a little bit, put it in the microwave for 30 seconds, take it out and wrap it around your head, leave that whole thing on for 20 minutes, take it off and wash your hair. Another thing I love doing is using olive oil. I'm gonna pour a little bit of olive oil in the cup, put it into the microwave for maybe about 20 to 30 seconds and just let it warm up. While you're doing that, you should microwave the hot towel as well and let that warm up. and then take the olive oil, apply it to the tips of your hair, maybe a little bit in the center of your hair right here, and then put a towel on, wrap it around, leave it on for 20 minutes, and then wash it up with shampoo. Now, a leave-in conditioner is basically a less concentrated form of conditioners. You take like maybe a tablespoon of your favorite conditioner, add some distilled water, shake it up, and spray it on your hair before you flat iron it or before you go out. I like to just do the tips of my hair because this is where I don't get any oil or any moisture on my hair. Another thing I do recommend, not only for your hair but your health as well, is taking vitamins. A multivitamin really helps your hair grow. And you know what? Prenatal vitamins, as scary as it sounds, it does work. It makes your hair grow really, really fast. Last time I made this video, a lot of people were like, oh my gosh, prenatal vitamins. I mean, if you take it, wouldn't it like induce pregnancy? But I did look it up. I did quite a few research and I haven't seen anything that proves that prenatal vitamins will make you more likely to be pregnant. It's just like taking a multivitamin, you know? You get your zinc, your vitamin A, B, M, E, whatever. You're gonna pee a lot of it out, so don't freak out about it. If you feel like taking prenatal vitamin, that's okay. Take regular multivitamin if it makes you feel better. I know people say this all the time, but sleep, stress, and water is a huge factor with hair growth, especially stress. Like when you're stressed out, your hair will come out like crazy. Drink a lot of water. It's good for your skin, it's good for your hair, it's good for your health. I mean, I really don't have to go into it, right? And keep in mind that if you don't sleep enough, you're gonna probably feel groggy, which also creates stress. So sleep kind of helps with stress as well. Now, another thing you have to remember is trimming your hair. And a lot of people say that you should trim your hair maybe 4 to 8 weeks. I try to trim my hair every 4 to 8 weeks, but sometimes I've gone as long as 16 weeks. And my hair gets really nasty and ratty at the end. Like maybe at home when I'm bored or something, I'll take really small clippy scissors and just maybe snip a little bit here, find some split ends, snips a little bit there. So I hope that was a lot of information that you guys could just maybe take, absorb, sit down, think about it, food for thought, right? And happy hair care. Bye.